Hello everyone, my name is Paulo Alves, and this is a series where I intend to show you the creation of a startup from scratch. So this startup is based on an idea I had with a friend for helping people with recycling and sustainability. So keeping it short, the idea is to build a mobile app where our partners are going to be able to inform us that there is some pickup trash to do in some place. And this place I'm talking about could be a house, could be an entire building, or maybe some company. And our clients will be NGOs and other companies that work with recycling. So we are going to provide to these NGOs and other companies the information they need and the points on the map where they should go collect that trash. So as I said in the beginning, on this series, I will show you the whole process of creating a startup, starting with the idea, then moving on to the design of the app, the programming of the app, finding new partners and new clients, and maybe trying to find some investors, who knows. I'm a programmer, right? So I also intend to put all the code that I write in an open source project where you guys can take a look in every single line of code that I will write. So maybe you can learn something new with it, or of course, teach me something new also. So in this first video of the series, I'm gonna explain you better the whole idea of the app. I'm also gonna show what we have done until now, which is only the idea and the design. And at the end of the video, I will show you how I plan to build this app. So let's start. As this is an app that will deal with recycling, we thought about this name, Recyclica, which is a combination of two words in Portuguese, my mother language, which is recicla and clica, like recycle and click. So Recyclica, recycle, click. Good idea. As the description says, this app will help the process of recycling household and business trash. So let's dig into the idea. Here we can see a drawing of what we think should be the MVP. MVP, for those who don't know, stands for Minimum Viable Product. So let me explain it a bit. First, we have our partner, which is a person responsible for a house, a building, or a company. Let's use you as an example. So the partner would be you, all right? You will receive some trash bags and a QR code that will identify that trash belongs to you. Also, we'll give you some instructions of how to separate the trash. We decided that for this first MVP, we are not gonna separate the trash on categories like plastic or paper or metal and so on. We are actually separated on categories as wet and dry trash. We came to this conclusion of separation by talking to our first client, our validation client, which is our first client that's going to help us build and test and validate the whole idea. After some time, when the trash bags are full, you will open your app or some QR code app, read the QR code, and then you will be able to create a pickup call to that pickup point. This pickup call will then come to our system, will be saved in our database, and will instantly be shown on some portal we will develop in the future for our clients. This portal will be used by our clients to know where they can collect the trash. So our clients will gather those addresses and go pick up the trash in these addresses. And at the end, this trash will be put in some storage place. It will be weighted. And as a reward, you, as our partner, will get some points in the system that later you'll be able to change for some stuff. So this is the flow we thought about for the MVP of the startup. And of course, this flow can change over time and probably will, especially when we start validating the idea and the app itself with our clients and partners. Some new ideas and new needs can come up. So like our client now needs an app so he can have a map, and with this map go through all the pickup points and mark them as picked up already, or I don't know. Some stuff can come up. So, all right, as I have shown you the idea, now let me show you the first design of the app that we have thought about to be able to make this MVP work. Let's dig into it. The starting point of that MVP will be a QR code reader, of course, as that's the main thing our partner needs to have to start a pickup call. This screen is used only for this. After pointing that QR code reader, our partner will be able to see some basic information as a map showing the location, the amount of points he already has, and the address details of that point. After taking a look at it, the partner can create a pickup call or just stop his interaction with the app there, in case he was just curious about knowing how many points he has collected already. Who knows? But for the sake of continuing the demonstration of the MVP, let's imagine the partner decided to click on the pickup button. So the partner clicked on that button, and on this next screen, the partner will just confirm his address details, maybe change something, and then do the trash pickup call. And that's it. He will then see a success page saying some vehicle will come to collect the trash. Pretty simple, right? So now let's dig deeper in the nerdy part of this presentation. Now I intend to show you the technologies I'm gonna use and how I'm gonna implement the app on the fastest way possible. For the front end, I decided to work with the Ionic framework for the app, and on the future with the Angular framework for the client portal. You can ask yourself, why am I gonna use the Ionic and Angular frameworks and not the React and React Native frameworks, or maybe the Vue framework or anything else that exists now? The first reason is I have a really strong background on Ionic and Angular frameworks, and I don't have that background in the other frameworks or other technologies. And the second reason for that is, yeah, there is only that reason. For the backend, I decided, at least for now, to do something really simple and serverless. So I chose to use Firestore from Google, which is a NoSQL database. It is very simple to work with and to visualize. And I'm pretty sure that by using these technologies, I'm gonna be able to build the app really fast and start the validation process with our clients and our partners, which is the main idea of an MVP, right? To start validating as soon as possible. Let me get even more nerdy here and let's dig into the structure of the development. I mean, how I thought about the development so it is really fast. So first I will show you only the stuff related to the setup of the environment, as installation of the tools needed for Ionic, the creation of the Firestore database, and the creation of our public repository. Then I will start building the front end. On the first phase of the front end, I'll build only the screens of the app. So I will dedicate myself on working on the HTML and CSS only. After this, we'll have the whole app designed already. So on the second phase of the front end, I already have a really good idea of all the data and all the information that I need to create the app structure for our MVP. Also, I will add the state management structure with NGRX. On the third phase of the front end, I'll develop the services that will, in the future, make the calls to our back end, in this case, to the Firestore database. Here, I'll keep using fake data, also known as mocks, and I also will create the actions of the app, like button clicks and page transitions. Then, I'll start adding the necessary plugins to the app, the first one being the QR code reader plugin. Finally, I'll add the location plugin, which is the geolocation plugin, which will give me the latitude and longitude of the client. Then I will geocode that latitude and longitude. By geocode the latitude and longitude, I mean taking that latitude and longitude and transforming it in a real address with street name, the city, zip code, and so on. And only after all that, I will build the backend, which will be pretty easy as it will be a serverless Firestore backend. Then finally, I will build the real app and install it to my Android phone, so you can see that nothing of that was in vain and that it really works. And it's also important to keep in mind that all this coding is going to be done using the best techniques of clean code and TDD, also known as test-driven development, which, by the way, are essential to any developer who wants to be called a real developer. So that's it for the first video. I hope you enjoyed, and I also hope that you join me on this quest for building a startup from scratch. I'm not sure where this is gonna take us, but I'm sure there's gonna be a lot of learning in this process. So please don't forget to click on the subscribe button, share this video with your developer friends and entrepreneur friends, and see you on the next video.